before you start studying to become a software developer, there are certain things you might want to know. For example, how easy is it really to find a job? Is it true what they say that it's easy to find a job? Surprise, it's actually not that easy. And if you're looking to hire a developer, you might ask yourself the following question: why is it so hard to find a developer that suits my skill set? And if I don't find this developer, then what can I do? So in this video, I will answer those two questions. First of all, if you are thinking that it will be extremely easy to start in software development and find a job, and it will always be peaches and cream, that is not true. In reality, finding a job in software development can be extremely hard, and it can take a lot of time. Why? Because in software development, there are tons of different stacks of software. There are tons of different languages and software, and it is quite complicated and hard to learn one, let alone learn them all. It is virtually impossible to learn them all and be up to date with all of them. And this question is also going to answer the second question: how do I find a developer that knows exactly what I need for my company? It's very simple. Most developers are human beings. That's right. Am I right or am I wrong? Put it in the comment sections. So most developers will not be able to know every single language stack in the world. That is impossible. No developer can do that. So the problem is that there is an inefficiency in the system where employers are looking for developers that know exactly the stack of software that they are working with. But in reality, that is not the case. In reality, people work with other stacks of software. People work with different languages. People don't know those stacks of software. They do know other types of software. So the reality is that when you try to find a job, they will ask you, each time you try and find a job, they will ask you for a different requirement, a different requirement, a different requirement. And from the developer's standpoint, it is extremely annoying and impossible, because then you will not be able to become an expert in one of those languages. So answering the question, how hard is it to find a job in software development? It can be crazy hard, because the hiring people, the people, the employers, the business owners, and the people they hire, sometimes they have no crap idea of how to hire a person in technology, because they think they should know every answer to every question. But that's totally impossible in programming, because people that study human resources are not people that actually know coding. They just know human resources. And human resources is an old business science that is not exactly that old. It's actually quite young, but it's a science that improves slowly. It's not a science that can grow like as fast as programming. So they come from a mindset where things are moving slow, and they think, oh, so programmers need to know this and this. They ask the owner of the business, okay, so this is what you're looking for. Okay, so that's what I'm gonna put. Okay, now do you know these technologies? No, okay, well then you're not the developer I'm looking for. And the problem with that is that they are missing out on good developers. And this is the answer for the question: how do I hire a developer that's actually going to get the job well done? Well, if you want to hire a developer that's actually going to get a good job done, you need a developer that not only has some of the technical skills, but also has the soft skills. The soft skills meaning skills of learning, skills of sharing and collaborating with other people, because those are key in order to program faster and meet the deadlines. Because if you want to program fast, you need a extremely experienced developer in exactly that skill set, which is very hard to find. And if you do, he might charge a lot, and it's not guaranteed that he will meet the deadline. Deadlines in programming are like rushing art, because programming is a art and a science, it is not possible to always meet the deadlines. So the thing is that people that try meeting deadlines, doing one single developer doing the job of five, it will take longer. That's reality. So the answer to the first question, is it easy to find a job in programming? Hell no, it's not easy at all, because the people that want programmers, they want them with the exact set of skills that they work with in their company, but they're not willing to train anybody. So if you don't meet that exact code, that exact encryption of their stupid requirements, you are stuck and you will not get a job. And that sucks. That's reality. So it's extremely hard, unless the guy in human resources, which usually has no idea about coding, doesn't understand that in programming, you can just Google stuff. Hey, oh, all right, I don't know that. So I'm not supposed to know everything. Okay, I didn't know that. I'm just going to Google stuff. And that's how I'm going to find my answers. That's reality. That's actual programming. A real programmer that has a lot of experience always uses Google. Doesn't matter if he has 10 years of experience or 40 years of experience, he will always use Google. He will always look up what he doesn't know. No programmer knows everything. So wanting to hire a person that knows exactly what you need done is like finding a needle in a haystack. And that's a problem that we have in the tech industry, that people want the needle in the haystack and they let pass people that have sometimes more talent, more abilities, are younger, are stronger, are more capable, are more willing. And they overpay for older developers that are just tired of it and maybe they're not willing to do it and so on and so forth. They don't give the opportunity to the young guys, because programming is like learning to play piano. Once learning to read music or play piano, once you understand the basic chords, the basic notes, it translates to every single other language. But the guys in human resources, they don't know that. They think, so I need a C-sharp programmer. And then they start searching for a C-sharp programmer. And if they can't find a C-sharp programmer, they go like, whoops, well, you don't know, we can't find it. What else can we try and find? Like, they don't understand that people can learn and adapt to technologies. And that's the problem in software development. So you guys let me know, should you still go into software development? Or should you go, for example, into accounting? Or should you go, for example, into medical fields or something? Because it is extremely hard to find a job. If you have 2, 3, 4 years of experience, people want you to know everything. And that's totally unfair, because they don't understand that knowing things doesn't define that you're capable of doing the job. Knowing things only lets them know that you know it and that's it, but doesn't reveal how your aptitudes, your abilities of solving problems that might arise further down the line that are not exactly related to the stuff that you already know. Those skills are better, because in the world of business, things will change. Things will adapt and evolve according to the market's trends and needs and the industry's latest trends. So expecting a developer to just know a skill is not, first, it's not fair. Second, it will waste your time and your money, because maybe you hire somebody that does have the skill, but he's not a nice person, or he doesn't like learning. He already has the skill, but he's not willing or is not capable of solving new problems and fixing and improving stuff. So, or doesn't work well with a team, or charges a ridiculous amount of money. And that's for reality. So guys, to wrap things up, finding a job in programming is hard, and it's hard because people just want software developers that know exactly the software stack that they're working with. And there's thousands of software stacks, thousands upon thousands. It's literally impossible for you to learn them all. It is impossible for a human to learn them all. And each time you apply for a job, they want another stack and another stack and another stack, and it's never the same stack. And it's not easy, and it's not fair to ask a person to know it all. You can't ask any human being to know it all. That's just ridiculous. And on the other part, the employers, why is it so hard for them to find the right developer? Because they're looking for the wrong set of skills. They're looking for only for technical skills, but they're overlooking the actual skills that are capable of solving problems. And in business, it's all about results, solving problems, not just the technical skills. At the end of the day, the technical skills will be outdated in a few years. And if you're not updating constantly, you don't have that ability of learning new things, of adapting new things. You just stick with the old, then you will be out of business sooner or later. So guys, I hope this was very helpful. Let me know in the comment sections, are you still going to study programming? Are you still going to hire developers? How do you hire your developers? What is the best way of hiring a developer for you? Let me know, guys. Take care.